Hey everyone, this is Ash, and how's it going? Today we've got an Airfix Great Model Railways GWR Autocoach, and this is a request from the Roden channel, of which details can be found in the description, who has requested me to do a more in-depth review on this 1979 model. Very nice stylish packaging, and if we just turn it around, the details are handwritten on the side of the box, of which the reference number is 54255-5, GWR Autocoach. And if we just turn the box around, this model is actually made in Hong Kong by Airfix Products Limited, 1979. So this model is a little bit older than myself. And so, without further ado, let's remove the packaging. Let's have a look at the model in more depth. Right. Without removing the track too much, and just taking off the lid of the tray, here is the GWR Autocoach. Nice amount of weight. Not too heavy, but not too light so it will cause any derailment problems. I have to say, for its age, the detail is very nice. You do have the metal handrails, as reflected by the light. A decent amount of glazing. And you do have the wide loop couplers, complete with standard buffers at each end. And if I just turn the model around carefully, you have the bell on the front, complete with another loop coupler. And if we just turn the model on the underside, considering this is a 1979 model, it comes with plastic wheels rather than the newer metal ones. So in my opinion, for its age, it's a very good model. I shall just move this tray out of the way, and I shall stop the video whilst I adjust the camera. So we're back in a moment. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Now that I've set up the GWR Autocoach onto the track, which will be just for some close-ups, I do tend to make adjustments whilst the camera is not filming, as I don't like to include any jerkiness in the video. But meanwhile, without further ado, let's zoom in on the front of this model. And as you can see on your screen, the detail is quite basic, but in my opinion, it is still very good, and the Hornby variant hasn't really changed much since Airfix first made this model. The warning bell on the left has been individually painted, which in my opinion is a nice touch. And you do get the moulded buffers and the wide loop couplers at both ends. However, I would have liked to have seen metal handrails on the cab access doors. But on the flip side, you do get a nice basic interior. The ventilation ducts have been nicely picked out on the top. And if we just carefully move alongside the model, the main passenger access door also has metal handrails. So again, a nice touch. And I do like the Didcot depot plate, I believe, or that could be a destination sign. So, for its age, it's a very good model, and I'd definitely recommend one. Taking into account that it's a 1979 model, I'm definitely going to give this an 8 out of 10. Apologies for that, I just sneezed then, so I had to crop that bit out of the video. And this draws my review and overview of the GWR Autocoach from Airfix to a close. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Have a good week and stay tuned for another video coming soon. And if you do have any requests, please get in touch and I'll see what I can do. But once again, thank you for watching.